夏季将近尾声了，您今年暑假如果有出国旅游的话，想过做什么特别造型吗？由于美元走强，所以今年到欧陆旅游的美国人特别多，暴增了55%，而他们的穿着呢，受到 TikTok 的影响，疯传欧洲夏日潮流。说到欧洲玩的游客呢，要仿效意大利的穿衣风格。他们心中的意大利风格有碎花洋装、全身亚麻服装打扮。如果穿得像欧洲人，真的是这么回事，才会不像观光客。但是呢，这种穿着往往会有一些些相反的效果，因为在地的人认为这些服装非常超现实。
身穿浪漫的碎花洋装，又或者清爽的棉麻服饰，出现在罗马的街头一点也不奇怪。但把这些显眼服饰穿上身的，却不是意大利本地人。
Perché cioè io la vedo dal punto di vista di magari una persona che non è europea, e quindi l'Euro Summer magari è qualcosa di interessante。
让当地民众啧啧称奇的，就是最近在 TikTok 上疯传一波叫做“欧洲夏日”的潮流，鼓励游客趁着暑假玩乐时，仿效所谓的意式穿衣风格。
A lot of people with Euro summer, they tend to wear a lot of bright colors, like pops of colors, a lot of linen, a lot of cotton, a lot of natural fabrics.
在今年造访欧洲的外国游客中，美国游客的人数预计会比去年多出55%。当中有不少人都想让自己看起来不像来旅游的观光客。
Honestly, this is a good store that's like pretty close to what we're looking for. Just all the florals, all the like dainty little pieces, mini skirts, like cute little lacy tops, all that kind of stuff.
只不过这样的临时刻意的仿效也引来不少反弹和批判，在欧洲夏日的影片底下留言。
A lot of people from like various countries in Europe were like, well, this is like a very romanticized version of our fashion, and it's not necessarily rooted in how we actually dress.
自二战以来 ，Armani、Prada 等多间精品品牌成立，让米兰有了时尚之都的封号。而业界认为，这也是大众对于意大利时尚出现刻板印象的开始。
Lo stile italiano, per quello che mi riguarda, essendo io italiano.Direi che l'aggettivo che meglio lo descrive, secondo me, è eclettico.
同样展现自我风格，还带一点有趣成分的场景，出现在美国明尼苏达州博览会的现场。
I was inspired to do like a 1930s, like Ukrainian or Budapest kind of immigrant attending the fair.
一般参观民众把展览会场当成了伸展台走秀，舒适度成了他们不约而同的穿搭共通点。
The Crocs are pretty comfortable. I like the holes.
符合今年夏季高温的还有应景的花衬衫。
It's weird to see people in long pants.
但这位老兄不止穿长裤，还是一条牛仔裤，加顶草帽，系上大扣环皮带，以符合自己的牛仔装扮。
Really not making that much of a statement. This is pretty much how I dress every day.
至于英国，最新潮流不在服饰配件，而是在自己的皮肤上。有人痛到紧闭着双眼，靠着听音乐转移注意力；有人则淡定拿本书来打发时间。而这些人全都来到今年的大伦敦纹身展，等待纹身师在他们身上完成新的印记。
I think the hardest part is convincing someone that they want to get the full torso done. You know, we started off with a sleeve.And then it just kind of expanded from there.
至于这位身穿蓬蓬裙的纹身爱好者来到现场，却没加入任何新的图案，因为全身除了脸，已经没有任何一块可以挥洒的空白处。
I just feel like this is how I've always meant to look. It's not even necessarily just about necessarily the tattoos. I just feel like this is me.
在英国，民众对刺青的接受度越来越高。根据2018年调查，近三分之一的英国人身上有刺青。比六年前多了16%。
There's still some misconception about tattoos, but you know, now the people expressing themselves a bit more, it's coming a new horizons for people as well, trying something new.
随着纹身需求提升，纹身师的挑战也就越大，因为人人都想要跟在自己身上一辈子的图案设计与众不同。
But I think more so these days, people want more unique tattoos. They don't want to just get the same thing.That everyone's got down the street. They want to show their tattoos off with something like original.
这场为期两天的纹身展共聚集400名优秀纹身师傅，当中约有一半是女性。
I mean, it's just because the tattoo artists, the whole community, everyone is so supportive and so understanding. There's no judgment. and we are all equals. Well, neorealism, it's something that the guy started to call the style I do because I mix so many different styles into my work.
随着夏季告一段落，新的潮流从何而起？从各大展览到日常街头，能看出端倪。TVBS 新闻综合报道。
想看最完整的新闻内容，记得下载 TVBS 新闻网 APP。